Late on a clear summer night in Ontario, a 10-year-old girl stepped out of her tent and froze, spellbound by the glittering expanse overhead. Sara Seager had never seen so many stars. My first memory of the stars is stepping out of the tent in the middle of the night while camping and looking up. I saw so many stars. Why hadn't anyone told me about this? She would later recall. But wonder soon met challenge. Her parents' divorce left her shuttling between a cramped Toronto rooming house and weekend escapes north with her father. At home, a dismissive stepfather quashed her early attempts at curiosity. "I don't know if I would be successful if I hadn't been so beaten down," she admits today. From that astonished child to a pioneer of exoplanet discovery, Sara Seager's story is one of unyielding curiosity, bold ideas, setbacks turned into springboards, and a resilience that has carried her through both professional storms and personal loss. In this episode, we chart her journey from cramped Toronto rooms to Harvard classrooms, from the cutting edge of atmospheric spectroscopy to the deep silence of space missions. This is a narrative not just of breakthroughs in science, but of a singular individual who followed a bright spark into the unknown. Sara Seager was born in 1971. From the start, her home life was a patchwork of stability and upheaval. When her parents divorced during her elementary years, Sara found herself navigating two very different worlds. On weekdays, she and her sisters lived in a cramped Toronto rooming house with their mother and a monster stepfather, who brooked no mischief or questions. Sara learned early to tread lightly, hiding her burgeoning curiosity under a carefully constructed armor. Yet come Friday afternoon, she would throw open her backpack, abandon school books, and race to her father's car for the 80-mile drive north. There, beside quiet lakes and dense pines, a different Sara emerged. It was in those weekend getaways that her spirit of exploration first took flight. Her father encouraged her to invent wild hypotheses: giant turtles buried beneath the Canadian Shield, meteorites that whispered secrets of the cosmos. Those tales sounded fanciful at first, but Sara learned that science blossoms on the wings of imagination, even when ideas seem outrageous. Back in Toronto, the harshness of home steeled her resolve. "I don't know if I would be successful if I hadn't been so beaten down," she reflected years later, acknowledging how her stepfather's strictness fueled a real lack of respect for all authority. While other children cowered under criticism, Sara honed a stubborn independence. She sought challenges, pushing herself to solve complex math puzzles and building crude telescopes from discarded lenses. Even in grad school, she stood out. At recess, she would climb the highest monkey bars, not for fun, but to measure how far sounds traveled across the yard. Teachers noted her focus. She rarely spoke in class, yet eyes that darted toward the ceiling suggested a mind far beyond the curriculum. Science textbooks gathered dust. Sara's real classroom was the night sky. Her first true scientific epiphany arrived one summer night in a clearing outside the tent. Around her, fireflies blinked like terrestrial stars, and overhead the Milky Way stretched in a shimmering arc. Sara felt a tremor of recognition. The universe was not a distant canvas, but a dimension she could explore. In that moment, her youthful wonder matured into intent. She would map those hidden worlds. In high school, she balanced her longing for the outdoors with a hunger for formal learning, tutoring peers in mathematics and physics despite her own ambivalence toward school science. She devoured library books on astronomy, from Galileo's sketches to modern astrophysics, teaching herself the language of spectra and orbital mechanics. These formative years, half under the weight of a stifling household, half beneath endless northern skies, forged the bedrock of Seager's character, a blend of skepticism, self-reliance, and boundless curiosity. In the fall of 1990, Sara Seager arrived at the University of Toronto, armed with an insatiable curiosity and a prestigious NSERC undergraduate scholarship that underwrote her double major in mathematics and physics. In lecture halls, she absorbed abstract equations and theoretical constructs. But her true classroom lay beyond campus buildings. Nights found her at the David Dunlap Observatory, a short drive from Toronto's city lights, where she cataloged variable stars and led observing sessions under a canopy of real ones. Peers, who slept through dawn lectures, watched her emerge at sunrise, bleary-eyed but triumphant, clutching logbooks filled with spectral measurements and orbital calculations. Graduating in 1994, Seager set her sights on Harvard University, envisioning a doctorate that would push the boundaries of planetary science. Her chosen topic was modeling the atmospheres of so-called hot Jupiters. These gas giants, orbiting perilously close to their parent stars, defied conventional wisdom. During her proposal defense, senior astronomers admonished her for pursuing what they deemed a speculative dead end. "It seemed as though every astronomer I told about my thesis topic advised me against it," she later recalled. Yet she pressed on. Sara's PhD years crystallized her methodical approach, framing big questions in bite-sized experiments. She devised simulations of sodium and potassium absorption lines, carefully comparing her models against scant observational data. The work demanded precision, tweaking temperature gradients by mere tens of degrees, calibrating pressure profiles within tight margins. By 1999, her defense committee recognized not only the rigor of her calculations, but the audacity of her vision. She had proven that these blistering exoplanets not only existed, but could be probed via their atmospheric signatures. Fresh from her PhD, Seager accepted a postdoctoral position at Princeton's Institute for Advanced Study, stepping into the role of de facto Planet Jones. In hallways lined with blackboards scrawled in abstract mathematics, she was the lone exoplanet expert. "I showed up and got to be the resident expert on exoplanets. I was the only one." Here she refined her transmission spectroscopy proposals, drafting mission concepts that would evolve into Starshade and Asteria. Surrounded by theoretical giants, she channeled their collective brilliance into her own designs, laying the groundwork for a career that would redefine humanity's search for other worlds. By the year 2000, Sara Seager had become fluent in the language of exoplanets, yet she faced the challenge of translating that language for anyone curious enough to listen. At its core, an exoplanet is simply a world orbiting another star. Every pinpoint of light in our sky could host its own hidden menagerie of planets. But to find these distant worlds, scientists must tease out subtle signals from overwhelming starlight. Sara embraced two principal techniques and then invented a third. Detecting exoplanets light years away is akin to spotting a firefly against a searchlight from miles off. Exoplanets emit no light of their own. They are lost in the glare of their parent stars, a few parts per billion fainter. Earth's atmosphere blurs starlight for ground-based telescopes, and instrumental noise can mimic or mask true planetary signals. Astronomers liken it to listening for a whisper in a hurricane. Every dip or wobble must be measured with painstaking precision over multiple nights and with redundant methods to confirm a true detection. The first method we use to spot exoplanets is called radial velocity method. In the cosmic dance, a star and its planet circle a common center of mass. As the unseen planet tugs on its sun, the star wobbles toward and away from Earth by a few meters per second, slower than a brisk walk. By measuring tiny Doppler shifts in the star's spectrum, its rainbow fingerprint, we can infer the presence and mass of a hidden planet. A red shift signals the star receding, a blue shift approaching. By recording these shifts night after night, astronomers reconstruct the planet's orbit and estimate its mass. This method revealed the first hot Jupiters in the 1990s, but its sensitivity wanes for smaller, Earth-like worlds. The second method that is used is called transit photometry. In photometry, we measure stellar brightness with extraordinary precision. A Jupiter-sized planet might dim its sun by about 1%, like a dimmer switch turned almost imperceptibly. An Earth-sized world causes a dip of a few parts per 10,000, detectable only with the most stable space-based instruments. By recording the timing and depth of repeated dips, scientists derive the planet's size and orbital period. Combined with radial velocity data, this yields both radius and mass, and thus average density, hinting at composition. Sara's true breakthrough came in form of transmission spectroscopy. It was in this arena that Sara left her most indelible mark. In 2000, she published a daring prediction. When a planet transits, a fraction of the starlight filters through its atmosphere, and molecules in that air absorb specific colors of light. Sara calculated that sodium atoms in the inflated atmospheres of hot Jupiters would imprint a narrow absorption line near 589 nanometer. To demonstrate this transmission spectrum, she modeled how a thin atmospheric shell would deepen the transit at that wavelength by mere one part in 10,000, yet visible with high-resolution spectrographs. When 2002 observations of an exoplanet confirmed the sodium signature, the exoplanet community was galvanized. For the first time beyond mass and orbit, scientists could probe chemistry and temperature in alien skies. Sara compares atmospheric scale height, the vertical distance over which pressure decreases by a factor of E, to how puffed up a balloon appears when you blow it up more or less. In planetary terms, a puffy atmosphere produces stronger absorption features. By measuring the amplitude of those features, we could infer the planet's gravity and, indirectly, its mass. But Sara did not stop at theory. She designed mission concepts to make direct imaging and atmospheric monitoring routine. Starshade is a sunflower-shaped disk, tens of meters across, flying tens of thousands of kilometers ahead of a space telescope. By blocking stellar glare with razor-sharp edges, the Starshade creates an artificial eclipse, revealing dim Earth-like planets otherwise lost in the sun's halo. Asteria cubesat is a few kilogram heavy marvel that demonstrated that a shoebox-sized satellite could achieve ultra-stable pointing and photometric precision, opening the door to large constellations of low-cost planet hunters. Sara foresaw how NASA's transiting exoplanet survey satellite would find the brightest, most easily studied transiting planets around nearby stars. Then, with the James Webb Space Telescope's infrared eyes, astronomers could capture detailed transmission and emission spectra, searching for water vapor, methane, or even oxygen biogenic byproducts. Through patient step-by-step modeling, rigorous observation, and visionary mission design, Sara Seager has united theoretical astrophysics and practical engineering into a new science of distant worlds. Her work transformed exoplanets from speculative into measurable, characterizable worlds, ushering in an era when the atmospheres of extrasolar planets are finally within the reach of our understanding. Sara Seager's groundbreaking work has garnered a cascade of prestigious honors, each reflecting a milestone in the evolution of exoplanet science. In 2007, the American Astronomical Society awarded her the Helen B. Warner Prize, recognizing her early innovations in atmospheric characterization techniques. This award, historically given to promising young researchers, underscored how her modeling of transmission spectra had already begun transforming theoretical concepts into observable signals. By 2007, Sara had joined the Massachusetts Institute of Technology as an assistant professor, and in 2010, she earned tenure, becoming one of the youngest tenured faculty members in MIT's Department of Earth, Atmospheric, and Planetary Science. 5 years later, in 2012, she accepted the Raymond and Beverly Sackler Prize in Physical Sciences for her precise measurements of extrasolar atmospheres. The Sackler, awarded for extraordinary contributions to astrophysics, singled out her prediction and subsequent confirmation of sodium absorption lines, an achievement that elevated exoplanetary research from cataloging orbits to probing chemical compositions. In 2013, Seager was named a MacArthur Fellow, often dubbed the Genius Grant. This unrestricted fellowship acknowledged her theoretical work on biosignature gases and fueled her pursuit of novel mission concepts, such as the Starshade and Asteria CubeSat. Her 2020 investiture as an Officer of the Order of Canada recognized both her scientific leadership and her mentorship of a new generation of astrophysicists. Canada's highest civilian honor signified national pride in a researcher whose childhood fascination had blossomed into international influence. Finally, in 2024, the Kavli Prize in Astrophysics, the field's equivalent of a Nobel, celebrated her pioneering role in exoplanet atmosphere characterization. Seager's methodologies now underpin every major exoplanet mission and inspire emerging scientists around the world. Beyond these research honors, Seager's talent as a science communicator and author has also been widely recognized. She authored two foundational textbooks, Exoplanet Atmospheres, Physical Processes, and Exoplanets, and her 2020 memoir, The Smallest Lights in the Universe, won both the Los Angeles Times Prize for Science and Technology and the Harvard Book Prize in Astronomy. Her clear, engaging writing has been celebrated in Popular Science, Discover Magazine, Nature, and Time Magazine. In her memoir, she recalls an epic canoe journey through Canada's rugged north, portaging through mist-shrouded lakes, paddling under endless twilight, and sharing campfire conversations that led her to Michael Weverick, her first husband. As her star in academia ascended, grant awards, lectureships, a growing team of students, Sara navigated the delicate balancing act of motherhood and early professorship. She often joked that childcare was her most unconventional research expense, and spoke candidly of nights spent on calls with colleagues in Europe while her toddler slept upstairs. In 2011, the trajectory of her life shifted with wrenching suddenness. Michael received a stage 3 cancer diagnosis just after their 40th year celebration. Sara described those months as an emotional roller coaster, punctuated by fleeting hope and devastating setbacks. Less than 8 weeks after planning their next decade together, she said goodbye to him. Friends and colleagues braced for Sara's departure from science, but instead she found purpose in perseverance. She channeled her grief into mentorship, encouraging students and crafting research goals that honored Michael's memory. She immersed herself in modeling exoplanet biosignatures. If the universe can endure its darkest moments, so can we. A new chapter began when she met Charles Darrow, longtime night sky enthusiast. They married in 2015. Today, as telescopes equipped with Starshades capture distant Earth analogs, Sara Seager's vision pulses at the heart of our search for life beyond our own world. Her story is a reminder that science advances on the back of wonder, resilience, and the bravery to follow a spark into the darkest reaches of possibility.